Once, there was this little girl who lived with her mother. They lived in a nice little house. And all around the house, they had a garden. And what a garden it was. And that garden was packed with vegetables. They had some vegetables that would grow above the ground and other vegetables that would grow below the ground. Then they had a fence all around that garden and the house. And then there was a field. And then there was the woods. And no one, absolutely no one, ever ventured into the woods. Because the gunny wolf lived in the woods. One day the mother said to the little girl, "Listen, honey, I have to go to the market and sell all these vegetables that we've been growing all summer. I can't take you with me because the market's far away. I'll be gone all day. You'll have to stay home by yourself. You'll be all right. Just whatever you do, don't go out of the yard. And don't go into the woods because the gunny wolf lives in the woods." "Mommy, you don't have to talk about the gunny wolf, okay? I know about the gunny wolf, all right? I know you know, Dad. I just wanted to remind you." "You don't have to remind me, Mommy. I'm a big girl." "Oh my gosh, don't get so upset. Well, listen, little lady, would you like to help me pick some vegetables?" "Yes, Mom." Little girl went and got a bushel basket. And she and her mother went out into the garden. And they started picking vegetables. Now, they picked some vegetables that grew above the ground. And they picked other vegetables that grew below the ground. They picked some carrots and beets and tomatoes and squash and zucchini and peppers and onions. And after a while, the mother said, "Oh dear, I can't carry any more." "Okay." And her mother lifted up that bushel basket and placed it on her head and said, "Now listen, honey, don't forget. Don't go out of the yard. Don't go into the woods because don't say it, Mommy. Or I won't say anything about the gunny wolf because you know about the gunny wolf." "You said it, Mommy." "I love you. Bye, bye, bye-bye." Mother opened the gate, walked out the yard, closed the gate, and walked down the path. The little girl, she watched her mother walk down the path. And she said, "I love my mommy so much. I do. I just do. She works so hard. She's so strong. She is. You know, she's always buying me things. She brought me new sneakers." "She did. I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to pick some flowers for her so that when she comes back home, I'll give her a nice bouquet of flowers and she'll know that I love her because I do." And as soon as her mother was out of sight, the little girl went out into the yard and she saw a beautiful red flower. She said, "This is great. My mom loves red flowers." And she picked that red flower. Then she saw a blue flower. And then right next to the gate, she saw a green flower and she picked that green flower. And then just on the other side of the gate, she saw a beautiful yellow flower. She said, "I just want to get that yellow flower for my mom. I know my mom told me not to go out of the yard, but I just want to get that yellow flower. Then I'll come right back. No biggie. I'm not afraid of any gunny wolf anyway, you know. I'm not. It's just going to open the gate. I'm going to go zoom, zoom. I'll be back in a flash." So the little girl, she opened the gate and she ran out of the yard, picked that beautiful yellow flower, and she was going to go back. But then she saw a purple flower. Said, "My mom loves purple." And she went over and she picked that purple flower. And then she saw another yellow one. I think it was a sunflower. And then she saw a blue one. Then she saw a red one. She saw a beautiful white one. Oh, and then she saw a pink one. And then she saw another white one, another blue one, and a green one, and a purple one. And before you know it, the little girl was deep in the forest. She forgot all about the gunny wolf. Here she is picking these flowers. She was so proud of herself. She said, "This is great. My mom's going to love this." The little girl, she felt so proud of herself, she sat down underneath the tree and she started to sing. This is a song she sang. "Kum kwa ki wa, kum kwa ki wa." Just then, out from behind the tree stepped the gunny wolf. The girl looked at him. And the gunny wolf looked at that little girl and said, "Little girl, sing that sweet song again." She was a smart little girl, and she thought, "I better sing." And she started to sing. Cum qua qui wa, cum qua qui wa. And she looked over, and the Gunnywa fell asleep. The little girl thought, I better go. And she started to run. And when she ran, it sounded like this. Pitter patter, 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 pitter patter. The Gunny Wolf woke up and decided to chase that little girl. And when the Gunny Wolf ran, it sounded like this. Hunka cha, hunka cha, hunka cha. And he said, little girl, why for you move? Little girl said, I no move. The Gunny Wolf stared at that girl for a little while, and then he said, sing that sweet song again. Cum qua qui wa, cum qua qui wa. And the Gunny Wolf fell asleep. The girl thought, I better go. And she started to run. Pitter patter, 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 pitter patter. The Gunny Wolf woke up. Hunka cha, hunka cha, hunka cha. And he said, little girl, why for you move? Little girl said, I no move. And the Gunny Wolf said, sing that sweet song again. Cum qua qui wa, cum qua qui wa. And the Gunny Wolf fell asleep. The little girl thought, I better go. And she started to run. Pitter patter, 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 pitter patter. The Gunny Wolf woke up. Hunka cha, hunka cha, hunka cha. And he said, little girl, why for you move? Little girl said, I no move. The Gunny Wolf stared at that little girl for a little while, and then he said, sing that sweet song again. Cum qua qui wa, cum qua qui wa. And the Gunny Wolf fell asleep, and the little girl looked, and she could see the roof of her house. And she saw the chimney. And she saw smoke puffing out the chimney. And she thought, maybe, just maybe, if I run real quietly on my tippy toes, I might be able to make it home before the Gunny Wolf wakes up. The little girl started to run real quietly on her tippy toes. Pitter patter, 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 pitter patter. She got around the first bend in the road and she picked the pace up a little bit. Pitter patter, 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 pitter. She got around the second bend in the road and she started to run a little faster. Pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter. She got around the last bend in the road, and she was into her running mode. Pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter. And she ran, and she ran, and she ran all the way up to that gate. She opened that gate, and that gate had three old, rusty hinges on it. And when she opened that gate, it sounded like, and she closed the gate. and she ran across the yard, pitter-patter, 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 over to that house, and she opened that door, and that door had three old, rusty hinges on it. And when she opened that door, it sounded like... And she closed the door. And she skipped across the floor, jumped into a nice, big, soft chair. She cuddled up, and she fell asleep. Now the Gunny Wolf woke up, looked around and said, "My gosh, I'm almost outside the forest. I better go deep into the forest where I'm the safest." And he looked on the ground. And what do you think he saw on the ground all around him? Yes, he did see the footprints. What else do you think he saw? The flowers. The little girl had dropped her flowers. And the Gunny Wolf said, "I think I'll take these flowers home to my wife." Because a wolf has a wife in the woods too. And he picked those flowers up and he started walking home. And you know what song he sang as he walked home? "Kum kwa kiwa, kum kwa kiwa." And that's the story of the little girl and the Gunny Wolf.